We're on problem 53. Which table below correctly describes the points of the exponential function f of x is equal to 3 to the minus x minus 2? And they all input the same x values, as far as I can tell. Yeah, they all input the same x values. So let's just figure out which choice works. So if we take f of minus 2, that's the first one they give us in the order. F of minus 2, that is equal to 3 to the minus x. Well, x is now minus 2, so the minus minus 2 minus 2. So what's minus minus 2? Well, that's the same thing as 3 squared minus 2. So that is equal to 9 minus 2 is equal to 7. I get that right? Right. Let me see any of these choices. Well, that's only one of them has that. F of minus 2 is equal to 7. That's not right. That's not right. That's not right. We hear when x is minus 2, f of x is equal to 7, choice D. And we could have just evaluated the other ones, and we probably would have agreed with all of these numbers as well. Well, that was a lot of copying and pasting for a fairly straightforward problem. Next problem. I already had it there waiting for us. Log base 6 of 40. Log base 6 of 40. So, in general, inspecting it, I think they just want you to figure out how do you figure out a logarithm of, you know, any arbitrary base of some number if you only have, say, a log base 10 function, which tends to be the case in your calculator. And I proved this in a Khan Academy video, but the general idea is if I have log base a of b, that this is equal to log base 10 of b divided by log base 10 of a. And actually, these both don't have to be 10. They just have to be the same base. 10 tends to be convenient. The other base that tends to be convenient is e. But anyway, let's use that property to solve this problem. So log base 6 of 40 is equal to log base 10 of 40 divided by log base 10 of 6, which is choice D. Choice D. Choice D. All right, next problem. Next problem. Copy and paste it. And just so you know, I don't like talking while I'm copying and pasting because I think it slows my computer down and then I start sounding like Optimus Prime. All right, Jonathan wrote the equation log base 6 of x minus 4 is equal to 0 on the board. He needs one clue for problem solving. Which fact provides the correct information that he needs to solve the equation? Well, I mean, I don't know if he needs any information. This statement is essentially saying that 6 to the 0th power is equal to x minus 4. And then you could add 4 to both sides, and he would get 6 to the 0th power plus 4 is equal to x. And I guess if he didn't know the definition already of 6 to the 0th power, he would have to know that, to know that it equals 1. So 1 plus 4 is equal to x, which is 5. So I guess he has to know that 6 to the 0th power is a piece of information. But frankly, I mean, well, this one wouldn't have been useful, right? 6 to the first power, that's not even useful, even if he didn't know it. 4 minus 4 isn't useful, even if he didn't know it. But 6 minus 4, no, even that's not useful. Yeah, I guess, yes, choice A. He had to know 6 to the 0th power is equal to 1. All right. Let's see. They have a couple of more. I'm going to copy and paste all of them at the same time. I'm getting bold. All right. Look at that. Let me clear all of this. Image, clear image, image, invert colors, and I'm back in business. There you go. All right, I never know whether I should use a dark colored or light colored marker, because if over here the light colored ones look good, but on the white, the dark, so who knows. Magenta tends to be good, maybe purple. What is the value of log base 3 of 27? So that's just asking 3 to what power is equal to 27? 3 to the first is 3, 3 squared is 9, 3 to the third power is equal to 27. So log base 3 of 27 is equal to 3. They, I guess, just want you to know what the definition of a logarithm is in that question. I'm noticing that there isn't necessarily a progression of difficulty in the problem. They kind of flip between an easy one and a hard one, and Who knows? They're just it's a grab bag of questions. If log base 2, oh, no, not log base 2, they're saying log of 2 is approximately equal to 0.301. And when people just write a log without a base, you usually assume it's base 10. And it's kind of like what you'd get in your calculator. If you just press log on your calculator, it's log base 10. So 10 to the 0.3 power is equal to 2. So if log base 10 of 2 is approximately equal to 0.301, and log base 10 of 3 is approximately equal to 0.477, what is the approximate value of log of 72? Log of 72. So let's see. I think we just have to do some prime factorization here. So 72, that's equal to the log. Let's think about it. That's the log of. That's the log of. Let me think about it. This is 36 times 2. Well, I don't know if that even helps us. Let me see. 3 to the 3 to the third. That's 27. No, I just want to make sure I get. This is 9 times. I want to make sure 9 times 8. So this is log of 3 to the third times 2 squared. Is that right? So this is log of 9. Oh, no, I made a mistake. Ignore that. So this is the same thing as the logarithm of 9 times 8. Fair enough. And so that's the same thing as the logarithm. Let's say the log of 9. Log of 9 plus the log of 8. Plus the log of 8. Fair enough. Well, that's the same thing as the log of 3 squared plus the log of 2 to the third, right? 2 to the third is equal to 8. Let's keep going. I think you see where it's going, right? 3 squared is 9. Okay. So log of 3 squared, that's the same thing as 2 times the log of 3. And the log of 2 to the third power, that's the same thing as 3 times the log of 2. And we know what the log of 3 is, and we know what the log of 2 is. The log of 3 is 0.477, so we have 2 times 0.477 plus 3 times the log of 2, plus 3 times 0.301. 3 times 0.301. So 2 times 0.477, let me do it here. So 0.477 times 2. 2 times 7 is 14. 2 times is 14 plus 1 is 15. 2 times 4 is 8 plus 1 is 9. 3 numbers behind the decimal point, 0.954. And then 3 times 0.301, that's easier, that's 0.903. If you add them together, I can already tell you it's going to be that right there. Right? It's going to be 1.857. It's choice D, problem 58. Problem 58. If x is a real number, for what values of x is the equation 3x minus 9 over 3 is equal to x minus 3 true? All right, well, if x is a real number, let's just play around with it. Maybe it's, you know, maybe it's just a truism. Well, no, it is a truism. Look at it. Let's multiply both. Let me write it. 3x minus 9 over 3 is equal to x minus 3. Let's multiply both sides of this equation by 3. You'll get 3x minus 9 is equal to 3x minus 9. So we could stop there. So if I take 3 times a number and subtract 9 from it, and if I said that's the same thing as taking 3 times a number and subtracting 9 from it, well then x could be any number. So it works for all values of x. All values of x. And you could keep solving this. Let's add 9 to both sides. You get 3x equal to 3x. And divide both sides by 3, you get x is equal to x. Well, that's true for any real number x. It's equal to itself. So that works for all numbers x. Let's see what else they have to throw at us. Let's see. All right. Let's do one more. So let me. I've copied, and now I have pasted. On a recent test, Jeremy wrote the equation x squared minus 16 divided by x minus 4 is equal to x plus 4. Which of the following statements is correct about the equation he wrote? So let's play with it a little bit. X squared minus 16 over x minus 4 is equal to x plus 4. The statement is always so immediately when you see something like this, in order to do this, what he had to say is that, well, x squared minus 16 is x plus 4 times x minus 4, and then that's over x minus 4. And then to simplify from this to that, he essentially canceled out both of these things, right? And that's fine. That's fine, assuming that this number down here is non-zero, right? If this was 0, 0 over 0 is undefined. Anything over 0 is undefined. So this is what his simplification is true as long as x does not equal 4. Because if x equaled 4, then you would have an 8 times a 0 divided by a 0. And 8 times a 0 divided by a 0 is not defined. So this doesn't work when x is equal 4. And if you think about it, if I were to graph this equation, or his original equation, it would look just like the equation of x plus 4, except it would have a hole at 4, because it's not defined at x is equal to 4. So they're not exactly the same. The graphs would be exactly the same, except at the point x is equal to 4. So the point is B. All right, and I'm out of time. See you in the next.